Palmyra is an oasis city in the Syrian desert, situated at the Ifka spring, which runs also today. It flourishes in the first 3 centuries CE, but we know that it existed millennia BCE as well. The city has left us with an immense amount of archaeological and also epigraphic, so inscriptional material, telling us about not only the lives, also the deaths of Palmyrenes over centuries. So it's an immensely rich archaeological site, and it's presently also on the UNESCO list of World Heritage Sites. In particular, the funerary sphere from Palmyra provide us with a lot of evidence about how Palmyrene society was knit together. Just one example is that Palmyrenes had themselves and their families depicted in the graves in Palmyra. These graves could actually take a variety of shapes. So in the first century BCE, we know that shaft graves, so small underground graves, was what was primarily used. But as Palmyra became richer as a society, graves were monumentalized. And in the first century CE, we see grave towers, monumental, up to 6 stories high, which could house several hundreds of burials. Later in the second century, underground graves, hypogea, were introduced. They were cut down into the bedrock under the desert and could house up to 400 burials over several generations. Temple and also house tombs were dedicated by elite families in Palmyra and could even be situated within the cityscape itself. Within the monuments, the grave monuments, mummification was the preferred burial form. It's not the sort of mummification that we know from Egyptian mummies, but it was basically a drying out of the bodies and then wrapping them in textiles and anointing them with nicely perfumed oils. And then they were placed, the mummies, on shelves in the graves, stacked on top of each other, and in front of them, portraits were located, which would tell the visitor to the grave who exactly was buried on this shelf. And that's why these funerary portraits really tells us an immense amount about Palmyrene society and its self-perception and development over at least 300 years, which makes this a completely unique situation within the Roman world. A variety of tomb types are encountered in Palmyra. And these include the shaft graves, the monumental tower graves, the hypogea, but also the temple and house tombs. These tombs were usually founded by one family father, sometimes together with his sons, and then they were extended over generations. Since the portraits then were put up in front of the burial niches, these graves turned into immensely large family galleries which held generations and generations of Palmyrenes, and where you could go basically and be confronted with your complete family history. The portraits were very often accompanied by inscriptions which give the name of the deceased and often his or her family genealogy, so family history, in up to 5 generations back in time. 3% of the portraits are also dated, giving us the exact date of death of the deceased. So that makes it very interesting to study these portraits in a chronological perspective as well. From the second century onwards, sarcophagi, so burial coffins, were also produced in Palmyra of the local limestones. And these sarcophagi had major lids with banqueting scenes, so scenes of feasting, where more than 10 family members could be depicted in one go, so to say. These would include both dead family members, but also living family members. The sarcophagi, of which we have more than 300 from Palmyra, which is an extensive number, were put up often in front of already existing burials in the graves, and in that way, they became part of the stacking aesthetics of Palmyra, where portraiture really was used to give dense images of the importance of the family, because the family stood at the center of Palmyrene society, which was structured tribally in 12 large families. In the Roman period, these tribes were reorganized into 4 large families. We don't know exactly how, but the epigraphic material tells us so. And from then on, these 4 families dominated the public and the funerary sphere in Palmyra. So, as said, family mattered a lot in Palmyra, and this was reflected in death as well. The tomb monuments, which were extremely visible to anybody coming to Palmyra or being within the landscape of Palmyra, were very important in the visual monumentalized landscape of Palmyra, and they were also constant reminders of the long history of the families and the tribes in Palmyra. So both to outsiders and insiders, they showed a lot about the societal structure of the society in these 3 centuries CE. The portraits also tell us specific stories about Palmyrene individuals, so men, women, even children are often depicted in the funerary sculpture. Each portrait really tells us a very individual history, because even though these many thousands of portraits resemble each other, they are also very different. But the bottom line is that Palmyrenes did put a lot of emphasis on family relations. And these several hundred of tombs found in Palmyra until now, about 500 has been documented, and partly portraits have survived in all of these. And these portraits and the graves are really reminders of the fact that Palmyra was ruled by very strong families, headed by family fathers. We, however, also have a set of legal texts which were often engraved in front of the graves, so on the facade of the graves, telling us about how it would work with founding graves and also selling parts of them over time. As said, family fathers usually founded their family graves and their sons could take them over, but they could also sell off part of their graves. We have so-called cession texts telling us about family fathers who sold off a niche in a grave with 24 buried family members to another family and said to that family father that he could take out 24 burials and put in 40 new of his family. So that also shows something about the dynamic development of these graves over centuries, so that although the family stood in the center, these spaces were still not static and they could be changed and even bought off to other families. But at the center of all these grave monuments stood the depiction of the individual. The portraits, no matter whether they were depicted on the reliefs, so-called loculus reliefs, on banqueting reliefs, or on the sarcophagi, they do tell us the importance about the commemoration of the individual and the place of the individual within the family. And this makes the Palmyrene material extremely unique, since archaeology really seldomly presents us with the possibility to investigate such tightly knit family stories. So what do the portraits from Palmyra and their tombs tell us about the society of ancient Palmyra? Well, the tombs of Palmyra and the portraits of the individuals and the family scenes really tell us fascinating stories about the families, their developments, and also their relations. So fathers were shown together with their sons and even with their grandsons, mothers together with their daughters, with their grandparents, nephews together with uncles and aunts, so on and so forth. And in this way, we really get a very vivid image of these families being dynamic and having a lot of focus on the closest family. The portraits and also the burial customs of Palmyra really tell us about the very tightly knit societal structure. And it's very unique that the funerary sphere gives us so much insight into how life was structured in living life as well, so to say, so in reality. Burial customs, funerary monuments, and the funerary portraits of Palmyra give us insight into both the living and the dead society of Palmyra. Both were really important. Since family really mattered in Palmyra, it was important to the living individuals and families to be able to connect to a long history and show how their importance was underlined, because they could point at their family graves, the tower tombs out in the horizon around the city, or the large hypogea, which were also extremely monumentalized. If you were really lucky as a Palmyrene, you could even point to your temple or house tomb within the cityscape and say, for example, there my grandmother is buried. And that gave you a lot of impact and influence on living Palmyrene society. So the funerary sphere and the sphere of the living was completely inseparable in Palmyrene society.